everyone! I've wanted to make a Disney crossover tutorial for a while now. And I've been asked by Roblox and MLP Fan if I could show you how I do a video. So, here we are. I'm not going to show you everything because my workflow is kind of chaotic as it is, and it would only confuse you more. But there are plenty of basic editing tutorials out there for Adobe Premiere Pro and Adobe After Effects, which are the programs I use. Enough with me babbling, on with the video. Step 1. Build your video. I have a scene here I created in Adobe Premiere Pro. It's a smaller version of what a full video would look like for me. Here, let me play it for you.
She's blood, flesh and bone. No touch, so silicone. She's touch, smell, sight, taste and sound.
To create a video, I start with a song I like and a vague idea. To find ideas, I usually ask myself a question and roll with it, such as, what if I made another Jim and Melody video, but this time I focused more on their friendship at the palace, using the song She's So High by Tal Bachman. After that, I import the song and the movies in Premiere Pro, and put them after the song on the timeline. Over here, I find the clips I'm looking for in the movies I'm using, either knowing the scenes from memory or by watching bits and pieces of the movies as I go, clump them all up by pressing C on my keyboard and R to remove the cutting tool, and put them to the beats of the song in my timeline. I overlap all the clips, one over the other, as I need for one scene. Background at the bottom, characters over it. Finally, it's time to mask.
Step 2. Import your clips to Adobe After Effects. I always open After Effects beforehand and create a new project. I use the dynamic link by selecting my clips, right-clicking them, and pressing, pardon my French, my programs are not in English, replace with After Effects composition. Premiere Pro automatically, like magic, opens up my clip in a new composition in After Effects. I'll import Manip by Manip to After Effects since it's much easier to stay organized this way. Alright, let's start. Step 3. Masking Manip by Manip. The first shot doesn't need any masking, but I wanted to show you how to reverse this scene. Right-click your clip and go to Speed / Duration. In the menu that opens up, choose Reverse Speed. And voila! We have an establishing scene shot. Back to Premiere Pro, I right-click the now pink clip and click Render and Replace. Now it's finished. For the second mask, I import this new shot in After Effects. Right-click, replace with After Effects composition. Again, not much masking to do here, but I don't want Sebastian to be in this scene, so I'm going to mask him out. This is a trick I learned from the Nameless Dolls videos. By pressing Ctrl plus D on your keyboard, duplicate the shot. Go to a part of the shot where Sebastian doesn't touch that spot on the ground. Then, right-click and go to Speed Duration. In the menu that opens up, choose Freeze Frame. Now our clip won't move. Go up to the top of your menu bar and click Pen Tool. Zoom in using your mouse wheel, space bar to scroll down, and quickly mask around the spot where Sebastian isn't there. Zoom out. Press M on your keyboard and your mask properties would appear. Click Inverse. Here we go, Sebastian is gone. But here, if we scroll up to earlier in the clip, you can see Melody is kind of also gone. So click on the little circle down here to keyframe your mask. Move around the little square so that Melody is visible, but Sebastian isn't. Keyframe it until Sebastian is completely out of the shot. Sebastian reappears later in the shot, so I'll do that process again to make him disappear once more. And that's it. That's how I remove some elements in After Effects. Now, I'm in Premiere Pro once again. Right-click, render and replace. Here we go. All right, here we arrive at a real mask. This is Jim's mop from Treasure Planet. Underneath that mop, I have a scene from The Little Mermaid Return to the Sea to use as a background. I open both of these clips in After Effects. First, I'll do the background, the easiest part. You can toggle one layer on and off by pushing the little eye icon. I'll do that for the mop for now. I want to use the background behind a waiter, so I'll freeze frame the background clip, like I did for Sebastian. Now nobody moves. Next, I'll press S on my keyboard and open the scale effect. If I drag the numbers up, my scene zooms in. I'll now just grab my background and reposition it until the waiter is out of the shot. I click the little eye icon, and the mop layer is back. Now, if I quickly left-click two times on my layer, the layer tab opens up. I zoom in with my mouse wheel, and click the Rotobrush tool icon in the top menu. Now I'll drag my mouse, as if I'm painting, over the mop. My After Effects is a bit weird, and now a lot of stuff happened all at once. I have to make the clip on my timeline a little longer again. Next, I have to zoom in on my timeline. This is the whole movie on my computer. This is just the clip I'm using. I have to drag this to the right, or else my masking won't last all my clip. If you get this orange message down here, it means the frame rate of your clip doesn't match the frame rate of the composition. It says my frame rate should be at 23.976. But I just go up to Composition, Composition Properties, and go to Frame Rate. I click 23.976. Now we're good to go. Here you can see that my whole scene is in pink. So what I do is I click Alt and drag to only select the mop. Now this frame looks good, so I go to the next frame. Doesn't look good anymore. Using Alt, I remove bits from the map I don't want, and by left-clicking and dragging my mouse, I can select what I want. I do this for every frame of the clip. I zoom in and out as I see fit. To make my brush size bigger, I click Ctrl on my keyboard and drag my mouse. To undo something you did wrong, click Ctrl-Z on your keyboard. Next frame, and the next frame, and the next frame, etc. Give me a minute, I'll just finish the mask for now. Okay, now that it's done, we can see the mop overlapping the background. Now the mop seems a little too big compared to the background, so I'll scale the background up again. Okay, now to make it look better. The floor is very shiny in this scene, so the mop should be reflected on the floor, I think. By pressing Ctrl D on the mop layer, I can duplicate it. Next, I'll right-click that layer. In the Transform menu, I click on Flip Vertically. I'm going to put the top layer below the second one by dragging the flipped mop underneath. I'm going to press P on my keyboard and pull the top layer down. Next, I'm going to press T on my keyboard and lower the opacity of the reflection. Finally, in the Effects panel, I'll search for Gaussian Blur. Drag it to the bottom mop layer, and I'll put it at 15 should do it. There. Now we have a reflection. How cool is that? My mop looks a little out of place against the background's bright colors, though, so I'm going to color correct it next. In Effects, Color Correction, I'm going to play with the brightness and contrast in Hue/Saturation. Play around with the settings and effects you want. It's really fun to match them all up. Copy-paste, using Ctrl-C and Ctrl-V, all the effects by using Shift and selecting the effects from the top mop layer to the bottom mop layer. Sometimes when I want to add some fancy lighting, I'll go to Layer, Create, and click Solid. Next, I'll choose the color of lighting I want. And click OK. Using the pen tool, I'll mask the new color to create a spotlight of sorts. By pressing M and going to the mask properties, I can make the edges softer. Finally, I play around with the blending modes and opacity by pressing T to get something I like. So now it's done. Back to Premiere Pro, right click, replace and render. Phew, good job if you followed all of that. For the next manip, I'll skip ahead to the sixth one. I want to show you how I make my characters interact. I have a copy of Melody's clip at the bottom for the background layer. Jim is on the middle layer. And Melody is at the top again. So now I import my three clips to After Effects. This scene will use the Rotobrush tool too. I'll mask both Melody and Jim and be back with you after the time lapse. I'll go to the frame where Melody collides with Jim. By pressing P on my keyboard, I open the position option. By clicking this little circle, I create a keyframe. By going backwards on my timeline, I'll position Jim so that he's out of frame first until he appears and Melody collides with him. And voila, it looks like they've collided with each other. Now I'm going to play around with color correction and some other effects to make it look as if Jim and Melody are in the same lighting, just like we did with the last manip. Thank you. the bullies from this scene. I'm going to create a solid and mask around the bullies so that they're not there anymore. Play around with the keyframes. There we are! The bullies are gone! Now we're done! Back in Premiere Pro, render and replace. Finally, I wanted to show you the very last mannequin for this scene. Here I have a shot of Melody, a shot of her necklace, and again, the background with the waiter. One background can be used for multiple shots if you manipulate it just a little. I'm going to flip it horizontally to sneakily make it look like it's another part of the floor. Next, I'm going to mask out Melody's face. You can use the pen tool or the Rotobrush tool for this. I'm going to mask it. Finally, here we have the hands holding the necklace. One option that isn't the Rotobrush tool that can be useful is a little hard to find. If you go to Effects, Obsolete, you can find the Color Key effect. If you select the purple background and play around with the settings, it'll remove flat colors for you. It doesn't really work with complex backgrounds, so I don't use it often. But it can be used here. I'm going to mask out some things that I don't want in the frame. Now, I'll play around with the colors and brightness and contrast. I want to make it all look cohesive within that scene. There we go! It's done! Back in Premiere Pro, render and replace. Finally, our last mask is done. Now here we are at the end of this tutorial. I'm going to do this for all the clips on my timeline using these techniques I showed you. And then, I'll show you what it looks like in the end. I'm done. Thank you so much for watching. Good luck, and don't forget to have fun. Bye!
She's blood, flesh and bone, no tubs of silicone. She's touch, smell, sight, taste and sound.